Hey guys, today in SAO Integral Factor, we are going to look into the secret that the floor 47 have. Just kidding. I'm just kidding, okay? Just kidding, just drop the hammer there. So today we are going to celebrate Koharu's birthday. I know that it's coming very late, by looking into the different role that she can do in SAO Integral Factor and helping us players to be able to do more damage. The first role is as a buffer, and this role is very free-to-play friendly, as all the skills that we have in here are the one that is easily obtainable from the gacha. Sword has a really good buff skill like this client skill here that increase attack by 19% for 25 seconds, and this Kirito skill that increase attack by 18.2% for 20 seconds. Also have a shield skill that increase attack by 9.5% for 40 seconds. And then there's also a Kirito 3 stars or 4 star skills that will increase your critical rate by 20.5% for 20 seconds. So all these skills are easily obtainable from the gacha. And with the 330 gacha pool there, I think there's guarantee that you can get that skills. And what's better about it is that if you put the buff skills on a switch and use it on Koharu, as you can see in here, I got 50 seconds buff instead of the 25 seconds that I'm supposed to get with the client skills. But the bad thing about this is that if Koharu use it, the skill again right away, then it will drop that 50 seconds to only 25 seconds buff. But she shouldn't be doing that often. And 19% attack for 50 seconds, that's a really good buff. Also, if you use it for a longer buff duration, just for example, is this one that have a 120 seconds durations on the buff, then you will get 240 seconds, just like what you see in there. That's a very long buff, just like when you use the crackers from the floor 20. The second one is to have a Koharu as a damage dealer. So as opposed to the free-to-play, this is only applicable if you have a really good skills that you cannot use on your main characters. So I don't have that, so I have to move all the skills on my main characters to Koharu, but this will showcase how much damage Koharu can inflict with the proper set. So I have a buff skill on my switch skills, and if I use that, as you can see, the Koharu now is doing 243,968 damage. That's a really good damage for Koharu. It will be a good damage on top of the one that you already do. And the third one is a combination of a damage dealer and buffer. So the idea in here is to use the skills that can do a lot of damage, but also can give buff to the players. So examples, the skills here, I'm just going to replace this with this skill that gives a critical rate. And then we have the one Wisachi skills that will give a buff that increase the switch damage by 280%. And then the skills here that will give critical damage 18.2%. And it also give additional damage based on my level. And then the skills here that will give 23% attack for 15 seconds. Unfortunately, the bonus on the skill does not apply to the players. And the last one here will give a critical rate 18% for 20 seconds. So this will ensure that Koharu can still do a lot of damage to the enemy and giving us buff that will be useful for our players. And as you can see there, I'm just using a normal attack, but I can still get a buff showing up on my players. Now the fourth one, this is going to be a more specific build, the auto attack support. So on this build right here, we are going to optimize Koharu so that it can use, so that my player can use auto attack properly. So on this first skill here, we're gonna use is the mismatch Celica, but if you have a better skills like this window of Bloom Kirito that has a longer durations for the buffs, that would be better. And the next we have the tactician Argo here to give the critical and the flinch resistance. Also the last two there is the HP buffs to give more HP to our players so that we get more additional damage. So the idea on, so if you don't have skill like the top speeders or the Bohemian Pain Argo or Discharge Koharu that will give buff for 30 seconds so that you can switch it to a different weapons. This is gonna be a good trick to use when we only have used it for Koharu. So the main usage of this is when we are going to use the rush. So we have the Winners of Bloom on Koharu on switch. So when we activate the rush and we will use the switch right away, that way we get the additional damage bonus. And then we can activate our auto attack since the buff lasts 15 seconds. And if we do the auto attack properly, by the time that the buffs almost runs out, our switch should be available again. So we can use the switch again to get the buff and do the auto attack until the rush duration is gone. So this is one way to do the auto attack on a budget. On number 5 is a debuffer roll. So on this roll, Koharu will use a skill that will give a debuff to the enemy. For example, is this mace skill that will reduce the enemy defense by 35%, and this skill here that reduce the thrust attack on the enemy, and the same as this one, also reduce this thrust attack on the enemy so that we can weaken the enemy. And also different examples for increasing the damage would be this kind of debuff here that will increase the damage to the trusting weapon by 23%, even though it is only 8 seconds. And the best of all is the skill that can give double damage on the next attack that we apply to the enemy. So this example here is the Trouble Rabbit Celica that will give the mark debuff when we use the switch. So put this one on the switch locations, but for this to be working, we need the skill that will have a slow first contact, just like this Alice skill here. So if I just do it normally now, it's doing 200,000 damage, but if I do it on switch, and as you can see, it's hitting critical, but it's doing 586,900 damage. So that way it will guarantee that our switch damage is doing 2x the damage next. Number 6, he has a role to help you farm. So on this build here, we're just going to use all the skills that has an AoE damage, so that when you do the farm on the floor enemies and you cannot beat the enemy with one skills, for example, then Koharu will be there to finish the enemy for you. So those are some of the roles that Koharu can do to make your player become stronger. If you have a different role that you think she can take, let me know in the comment below and I'll be glad to discuss about it. So, now that I've made the video for you, Koharu, will you look at me in the eyes?
No.
Ugh, looks like your menu windows is more interesting than me. I'll just do a gacha pull. Koharu, so you still care about me?
Baka.